after that, Freddie Hirsch called me to the children's barracks he was heading then, and he asked me if I could paint something on the wall for the children. And I said, well, if you can get the materials, he said, I'll get the materials. I said, okay. And then a very handsome young blonde man from the men's camp came over one day, and Freddie Hirsch called me to come and meet him. And he asked me what I need, so I said, well, if I can get any wall paints, so any tempera paints, I would like those, if you can get me some. And he said, yes, anything you want. And so before I knew it, Freddie had the stuff ready for me, and I started painting. At first, not knowing what, I looked at that huge drab, it was kind of olive-colored, like all the barracks were, wall, and I thought, well, the thing to do is to make it look like we are in a Swiss chalet on the deck, and there is a balustrade with flowers on, flower pots on it, and we are looking out at the beautiful meadows and maybe see some cows and sheep and stuff. And I started painting, and I got through with the balustrade and the flower pots, which I made cartoony, incidentally. I made the trompe d'oeil, so they looked like they were really three-dimensional. And the flowers were all cartoony flowers, like in the old cartoons, like tires instead of petals, you know. And all that very, very plastic, very three-dimensional. And then afterwards, far in the distance, I was putting some sheep and some cows. And then I noticed that all the kids were standing around me, behind me. So I turned around and I asked them if they would, do they have any special wish what to put in that meadow? And they said, Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs. And that was a very surprising answer. But since I had seen the picture 7 times before, even while Jews were not allowed to go to the movies anymore with my star in my pocket, I had memorized everything, down to the soft shoes, the way they moved and everything. So I made a painting of Dopey standing on another dwarf's head with a cloak around him, so he looked like a tall guy, so he would be as tall as Snow White. And they were dancing together, and the shoes, those soft shoes and everything. And the kids loved it, and I made some other dwarfs around, one who was playing the accordion. I think that was Grumpy, the mean one. And the professor with the glasses. I made almost all the dwarfs standing around. Some of them were clapping, and that's what the kids liked. I now understand that there was another painter who continued something, painting on the walls after I have left.